गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट। टुडे इन चैप्टर नंबर 6 भक्ति एंड सूफी ट्रेडिशन आवर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज पॉपुलर प्रैक्टिस ऑफ इस्लाम एंड वी आल्सो डिस्कस अबाउट द सूफिज्म। पॉपुलर प्रैक्टिस ऑफ इस्लाम द डेवलपमेंट्स दैट फॉलोड द कमिंग ऑफ इस्लाम वर नॉट कन्फाइंड टू रूलिंग एलाइट क्लास। It means the changes which we seen in the Islam religion that was not up to the ruling class, ruling elite class. In fact, they permitted far and wide through the subcontinent among us different social strata like as the peasant, artisans, warriors, merchants and many more also. They were also adopted the this changed Islam religion. All those who adopted this Islam religion, in principle, the five pillars of the faith. It means that those who follow this, those who adopted this religion, they have to obey this five principles, which one also called the five pillars of Islam. Here you see the first one. There is only one God. That one is Allah. The Prophet Muhammad is his messenger. The second one, offering prayers five times a day. Five times a day, that one known as namaz. Then giving the alms, which one called the zakat. That giving the daan or alms or zakat to the needy and the poor people. Then fasting during the month of the Ramzan. From morning to from sunrise to sunset, performing the pilgrimage to Makkah or Hajj at least once in his life, every Muslim has to journey to this Makkah or Hajj. Hajj or this Makkah, as you I think so know that this is the pilgrimage center of the Muslim people. The popular practice of Islam, universal features of Islam, decline due to the sectarian practices, Sunni or Shias. In class 11th, we already discussed that after the death of the Ali, the Islam religion was divided into the two parts, the two sects that were known as the Sunnis and Shias. And the influence of the local customary practices. For example, Arab Muslim traders who settled the Malabar coast adopted the Malayalam language and maternity system. The best example of the blending of the universal faith and the local tradition is mosque, masjid. Okay, on that time, from north to south we saw the different type of the mosque. Architectural feature of the mosque are universal. From north to south, east to west, we saw a different type of the mosque, and their architectural features were also different from one place to another place. The orientation towards Makkah and the placement of the mihrab or prayer niche and the midbar or minars. There are variations such as the roof and building the material. Now I am showing you some pics of the mosque. This is the Chairman Perumal Juma Masjid, Kudub Galore. Here you see the architect of this masjid. Now this is Malik Dinar Mosque, Kasaragod, in Kasaragod. Now the shape of the roof and other things also very different. This is Charkol Mosque. This is Wala Patnam Mosque. Now this is Atiya Mosque, my Mansingh district, Bangladesh, built with the bricks in 1609. This is Shah Hamdan Mosque in the Srinagar, on the bank of River Jhelum, built in 1395. It is one of the best example of the Kashmiri wooden architecture. This mosque is very, very beautiful. Now, the growth of Sufism. Sufi were a group of religious minded people in Islam. Question mostly comes, who were Sufis? So then you have to write down this line. The Sufis were a group of the religious minded people in Islam. They were critical of the dogmatic definitions, and dogmatic means given to the expression of opinion very strongly or very positively. Okay, so then they were critical of the dogmatic definition and scholastic methods of interpreting the Quran. They emphasize interpretation of the Quran, but on the basis of their personal experiences. They follow the Quran, but the interpretation, that is explanation of the Quran, they were given only on of their personal experiences. Now the growth of Islam. By the 11th century, Sufism evolved into a well-developed movement with a body of literature in the Quranic studies and Sufi practices. By the 11th century, this new path, this Sufism, as you know that, the new path, which also based on the Quran. But in the 11th century, this new path was evolved, and we saw that development. But the main base was the Quran. Okay, Sufism was organized in an institution around the auspic or the khanqa, controlled by a teaching master known as the Sheikh, Peer or Murshid. It means like as a teacher who teaching his disciples. Okay, and he made this, he organized this institution, and this, the name of this institution is like as the hospice or the khanqa. He enrolled disciples, people from the different religion or the anyone who enrolled as a disciple in this hospice, and appointed a successor. He established rules. It means that after the death of the sheikh or the peer, the best disciple appointed as a successor of that hospice. He established rules for spiritual conduct and interaction between inmates as well as between the lay persons and the master. In this hospice, they established their own rules and rules for the spiritual conduct. Okay, and interaction between the inmate. Inmate means disciples, murid, students. Okay, as well as the lay person, the common people, and the masters on that time. Okay, student. Thank you.